welcome. Welcome to our Tuesday game. I knew this week was going to be different. I mean, I said after the game yesterday with Michelle, when we had the Banker's Gamble, that I thought it was going to be different. And we've got something very, very different. We have 22 identical sealed boxes, and we normally have 22 players. We've had more than 22 people here before, because, of course, we had Mark with his signer, Barbara, so there were 23. We've had 23 creatures here. Because, of course, we had the lovely Eric and his guide dog, Finn. But we've never had 23 players. Look at this. We've got Zara and Zoe, giggling twins. It's great, because they don't talk. They just giggle. And so we're going to be playing Giggle or No Giggle. Ooh, I hope we're going to be laughing at the end of your game. Troy! And now it really is your big moment. The chair awaits. Join me.
Thanks. Thank you.
How are you feeling?
I'm all right. I'm not too bad. Ask me again in 5 minutes. But I'm all right. No, it's good.
Good.
Do you believe me?
No.
No.
Your moment has come. Troy Appleby from Staffordshire, but you now live in Bristol.
I do.
Your partner Dan is here. Hi, Dan.
Hello, Noel.
Okay, how are you going to play this? Are you going to play this together, or are you just here to watch his agony?
I'm not looking.
Your friend Kat's here. Hello, Kat.
Hiya.
You two look as frightened as him. It's dead easy. It really couldn't be easier. You just choose the right boxes and you go away with a huge amount of money. Now, you've had some ups and downs. You used to manage a pub in Bristol, but that all went fairly up, didn't it? How did that happen?
Did. Basically, Dan and myself were the managers of a pub just around the corner, and the brewery had to sell the lease on to somebody else. They had their own people. We had a four-bedroom flat at the pub. And obviously our jobs, but within the space of a day we lost it all.
What's the next move after a shock like that?
The next move was to pack up quickly and downsize from a four-bedroom flat to a room, which is where we've been ever since. Box 12 could change everything.
It could indeed. You got some pics here.
That's my mum Mary. Mm-hmm. She lives up near Birmingham, a place called Lichfield. She would have come down today, but you're not Terry Wogan, so she didn't. But I said, Noel is a nice man, is a nice man, but no, she's dead set on Terry. You know, she's past 60, bless her, so, you know. You just sort of agree with her.
Eat your heart out, Terry. You happy to crack on?
I am. Let's crack on.
I need you to confirm, please, that you chose box number 12 at random before the game began.
I did.
It is sealed by the independent adjudicator who seals all 22 boxes and is the only person who knows where the money is. You got a system?
To win as much as possible.
Sounds like a good one. Troy! Dan! Good luck!
I'm going to ask you to confirm that box, yeah?
Yes.
I've done that. Shall we start again for you, Dave?
I'm sorry.
What are you accusing me of?
I must have been on dreamland, mate. I'm sorry, I do apologise.
Dave?
Yeah.
Out.
All right.
Nah. I mean it, out. Get out of this studio.
I'm going.
Go on. Move it. Go on, I want to hear that door slam behind you. Okay, we'll play on, and Steve or Hayley could open the box if you want to go with that. Not having that.
Shocking.
The next thing is they'll be bringing Terry Wogan in to do it.
Oh, please, me mum. She'll be down.
Well, I'm hanging on by my fingernails here. I'm not having it.
I think I'm going to go for box 8.
Are you?
Yeah.
All right. Okay.
Can I ask something really bizarre?
Go on, then.
Seeing as Dave's gone, can I open it?
I cannot think of a reason why you shouldn't. Yeah. Okay, over you go.
Come on, over.
Okay, we're going to box number 8. Troy, I want you to get Troy's game underway with a blue. Don't you dare spoil Troy's game, Troy.
It's going to be a blue.
Yeah, go. Yes! Good start, Troy.
That went quite well. Can we send everybody off one by one?
It would be a very different show,
it
wouldn't
would.
It?
Yeah. It would.
Okay, good start.
Brilliant. Elaine, number 18,
please.
Ah,
the charming, beautiful, lovely, feminine Elaine. Have you spotted me doing anything wrong then, have you?
Not yet. Okay. I'm looking, I'm watching.
Yeah, okay, Elaine. All right, well, in your own time, just if you wouldn't mind opening box 18.
Can deal with that. Can deal with that.
It's okay. Never forget, the banker always says if he was playing the game, he'd take out all the low reds in the opening round. That would be his dream start. So 10 grand, despite the groans, it's okay.
The only way to win the 250 is to take every box out before it.
What happens when you get to the end and there's one over there and one here and we open this one first?
We'll get to that bit later.
Right. So you were nearly right, but you weren't 100% accurate.
No,
I know what I mean. Sorry to be pedantic.
Terry wouldn't have said that. He'd have agreed. Emma, number 3, please.
Yep.
Mandy, you are sparkling at me with the jewellery. So I'm going to go for number 5, Mandy, please.
Good luck.
£50,000. That's what generates the...
Kelly, the lovely Kelly, number 1, please.
1p, please, Kelly.
Trying my best for you. Look.
Now that is very unfortunate. 35,000's gone. 2 of the power 5 in the opening round, not good news. Interesting opening round. One of the players disappears and 2 of the power 5.
It'd have been better if the 35 was still there. And the 50.
Yeah, and Dave?
I don't know, I did quite a good job of that.
I'm not missing him.
Oh, could be worse.
Hello? Oh, he really, really enjoyed your opening round. Says it would have been better if Wogan had been in charge, but anyway. Yes, we've got twins here. Where on earth did we get them from? They are a little giggle fest. They do. They do it in harmony, unison. Do you talk at the same time, the banker wants to know?
No.
I think that's a yes. It is quiet without Dave, isn't it? And it smells nicer as well. You feel sorry for him? Oh, you know what it's like to be an outcast. The banker is asking you, somewhat bizarrely, whether it's okay if Dave could come back in. Yeah?
Yeah, do we think?
Yeah!
Get him back.
It's okay for him to come back in. Dave, you can come back in! He's having a real bizarre moment. He thinks that Dave is now going to be on his side, and that in your game, he is going to be a Trojan horse. Yeah, and he said while he was outside no one was looking, he stuffed him full of little bankers. In the middle of your game, they're suddenly all going to burst out and take control of it. Yeah. Hundreds of them. Ooh. Yeah. Oh,
there's a few.
Oh, well, we're not going to sleep during this game. He's been looking forward to your game, Troy.
Has he?
Good. Yeah. He says you are one of the most popular players that we've had. An all-time popular player.
Oh, that's nice of him.
Yeah, and he means it. And he says these are always tricky games for him because he knows that you will be carrying the East Wing and the West Wing full support and no doubt the Pilgrims as well. So he feels everyone is against him. That always makes him just a little bit perky. Thank you. Well, despite the 35 and the 50 saying ta-ta, you've got £9,000 as your opening offer.
That's not a bad offer at all, is it?
It's a very good offer.
Very good offer. I'm ready for the question, though. I've been dying to say that. I really have. Can I say it again? I'm ready for the question, though.
£9,000. Deal or no deal?
Thank you very much, Mr. Banker. Excellent offer, but no deal. Get some blues. Diddy, you having any vibes?
I don't know.
Try the tactic that nearly worked yesterday when she was 50p Diddy and see whether she can be P Diddy for you.
Oh, yeah.
P Diddly do. I'm gonna go for Nola like. Graham.
Well, we haven't had much chance to get together. Well, to not get together, sort of. I'll start again, okay.
So, are you suggesting that I'm also a bumbling idiot? I have no hesitation in throwing another one out if necessary. If you're gonna open your mouth, try and make some sense.
I hope it's blue for you.
Thank you, Graham.
So do we. So do we.
Good start. Thank you, mate. Thank you.
It's a fascinating game, this. We've, in gameplay terms, lovely fallback there. He's still got the top three there. We started off with 23 players. We went down to 22 because of his misbehaviour. We're going to go down to 21 if he carries on like this. Come back after the break and find out just how many people are playing Deal or No Deal. Welcome back to Troy's Game. So far, we still have the full complement of players, but anything could happen. I'm feeling good about your game, Troy.
Yeah.
But you've got to get to the next phone call, having had another one at the top left, I would say. Mm. You want to make a hole in there.
Yeah.
Look at the smile from Hayley.
She's always smiling.
Oh, she's
always
gorgeous.
Smiling.
Thank you.
Yeah, going with Hayley?
No. Not this time.
Well, choose somebody else I can give a compliment to.
Pete, and there's so many compliments this guy could have.
I'm steering away from his story, savouring it for when his game comes. I think it's going to be a really inspirational show, but let's just... We'll save your story, Pete, but...
Well, in the meantime, you're both going to be missed, Troy.
Thanks, mate.
Good luck.
Oh. That really was truly inaccurate shooting. I wanted a whole top left, not a whole bottom right.
I should have gone with Hayley, shouldn't I?
We'll see. That'll be interesting. Let's put a mental tag on 22 and see if you had gone there, what would have popped out? Because it could have had a fundamental effect on this. Hello? Oh, yes. Peter, that's his kind of hole. That's your Grand Canyon, yeah. That's quarrying on a major scale, wasn't it? What is Graham on about? Don't look, please. You say he's a pale imitation of me. What do you mean, he looks like a bucket?
Nothing personal.
What would you love to see? You'd like to see me and Graham go on a double date with Zoe and Sara. The two of us should take the girls out one evening, take them through Bristol, and there'll be a rush of eye tests from people going down. It does look very different. It was a great round, but it had a terrible sting in the end. Yeah, you can see his point of view. How, by taking out the 250, you know, suddenly the other holes, the lower holes, now look to be gaping holes. And that's why he's now cut you to 2,500.
Ready for the question? No.
£2,500, deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you.
You don't even have to say anything.
That desperate to get people.
Yeah, I'm gonna go for the twins.
Are you?
Yeah, because I want to know how they're gonna open the box.
That's a good point.
I thought there might be two tabs on, but
Well, now I assume that the Giggle Sisters have been practicing.
We have.
Welcome to the game.
Thank you.
And hopefully, it won't be B. Curse of the newbie. I'm looking forward to seeing this. You're going with box 17?
Yes. Yeah? Number 17.
Okay.
Oh. Ooh. 3,000. Thank you. Let's get on them blues.
You're having a problem with that top left corner.
Yep.
Is it time to ask everyone to lean to the left, Troy?
To lean to the left?
Works. Works every time. But it's not a tactic that I recommend using too often.
What, leaning to the left?
Yeah. East wing, lean to the left.
Now, they weren't sure which was left then, were they? That's shocking.
West wing, lean to the left.
Wait.
Pilgrims! Lean to the left! And hold it there. Right, okay. I'll do the same. Where are you going?
Number 15, Martin.
Okay, please. You're the only one who's allowed to stand up because it's not easy to do. Get on with it, it's not that comfortable.
Good luck, mate.
Yes!
Thank you.
We like this way. Thank you. Not to be overused.
Jack, number 10, please, Jack. The penny, please.
I hope so, Troy.
Yes!
Thanks, Jack. Thank you, mate. Yeah, that little lean to the left. Yeah. Thank you for that.
No, my pleasure. Don't forget, I have an arsenal of weaponry under this table. Wanted the lucky slippers? No? Okay.
No. I've seen what comes out of your
arsenal. Hello. He says, what on earth's going on down there? He says, it's more like a mental institute. Every day. Did you call the pilgrims leaning? He's had to adjust his screen. Yes, a much improved round. Yeah, there's a lot of love in the room. We're doing okay. Wee. OK, he's feeling the love in the room, the support, the conviction that you are going to do rather well. And then it's that lovely moment when he sucks his teeth. I know that doesn't sound very pleasant, but he does all that. And then he goes, 10 grand.
That's another fantastic offer, isn't it?
Very good.
That's brilliant. £10,000.
Troy, 4 good sums of money still left on the board, and still quite a few blues to aim at. There's one more there.
Yeah. This is my favourite bit. I'm ready for the question.
£10,000. Deal? Or no deal?
Amazing offer, Mr. Banker. Thank you. But no deal.
Thank you.
Number 2, Alan, please.
Over to Blue Troy.
Thanks, Alan. Number 7, Betty, please. Oh, that's all right. That's all right.
The drama.
Thank you, darling.
Right then, one to go. We'll be at 8 box. As you know, it's always great if the imbalance is that way.
Oh, did he? Bless her.
Oh, what's wrong?
She's just lovely.
Got terrible arthritis.
She's got something else as well, but I can't mention that. The first word she ever said to me behind the wing, but I won't mention that.
Don't you dare.
Oh, come on now. Oh, come on.
Can I tell him?
Oh, go on.
Her first day, she comes walking up, said, oh, I just let you know now, I do suffer with a lot of flatulence. Thanks, did he?
I was only joking.
But she's kept it in.
Well, it's an ill wind, and we now have to break that wind. It's time for a break. We'll be back when hopefully Troy will have 5 on the right and 3 on the left. Great atmosphere here, really a fantastic atmosphere of love in the Dream Factory. And you're right on the verge of a very strong 8-box offer. Just want to find a blue.
Number 11, Steve, please.
I so hope it's blue for you, Troy.
Cheers, Steve.
Good luck.
Yeah! Oh,
good.
Thank you, mate. Thank you.
Given the couple of setbacks you've had, I think you're in a very strong position now.
It's
15, 20, lovely block of fallbacks, 75 and 100 still in play. Feeling good. Hello. Oh, you sound like you're chewing wasps. He's going, not happy. Aww. Aww. Waves of sympathy there. The only bright spot in the whole round was finding out that Diddy has flatulence. Breath of fresh air to him it was. He says not so much P Diddy as Poo Diddy. no choice. One P, £1, £15,000. The box number 12. Highest offer so far.
Kat, what do you reckon? It's quite good.
You've got a strong board, but.
But if the 100, the
75, or the 75 go,
and the
you're,
20 go,
it's 15K is a lot of money.
Of that's somewhere for us to live. It is really, really difficult.
Troy, that's a gambler's board, mate.
It is a gambler's
What's
board.
What's the 15,000 mean to you? We keep saying it every time.
It means...
You've still got four good figures there, and the 15,000's one of them.
If I gamble and I lost, that's our life just...
Yeah, he's not going to offer you 15 again if you take them three out, boy. The odds are taking the three out.
Troy, I know it's a lot of money. It is a lot of money. But I think we saw some games last week where people were in the position you're in now and may have wished they took that chance.
Yeah, that's what's going in my head. But then one side of me is saying exactly that, Mandy, and the other side is reflecting back to Olga and to Derek, and obviously it's different, but...
Hey, listen, mate, we're right behind you no matter what you do.
Ready for the question, though?
£15,000. Deal? Or no deal?
It's a brilliant, amazing offer.
Interesting point. He said, I feel as if I've let myself down. That's a very interesting... That's an interesting comment. But £15,000 is parked. It is reality. It is now yours. Don't think about anything else but moving on and playing the game, Troy, please, with total honesty. We now wish you to prove it wasn't just a wise life decision, it was a brilliant game decision. And a lot of people watching you now suspect there was one more round in it. Troy, the next box.
Right. Lovely K, number 14, please give me a big fat red.
This is a hot box.
A hot box.
We want an inferno out of that box, Kay. No, not good enough. Not good enough. We would have been cheering. That was most certainly one that we were happy to see if you had said two words rather than one. Now the pressure is really on. Two boxes, and you've got to find the two big ones.
And number 13, make it a biggie.
Got to be a biggie. It's got to be a biggie. One of the two. No, no. Funnily enough, even that now is not good enough. It would have been disappointing if we were still in live play, but it would not have dashed your hopes. And now, if this is 15,000 or one of the blues, you made a big, big mistake.
Julie, number 6.
We're with you, please. Julie. Will you open box number 6 and reveal £100,000, please? No.
Oh, God.
Oh, wow, Troy. Well, you got the answer to the question, did you go too soon? You undoubtedly went too soon. Oh, dear me. Dear me, dear me. I think this could be very uncomfortable. Hello. What do you want to say? He says, I would like to say something. Ah, Troy, you've not let anybody down. Least of all the banker. You said you felt you'd let yourself down. I don't think you meant that. I think what you actually meant was, unfortunately, in the head-heart war, the head had to win because you need better accommodation. So you had no option, really, but to take 15,000. I think in your heart you did want to go on and play the game. It's a great shame the blood pump didn't win the battle, because now you would have the opportunity of walking out of here with £28,000. There were a lot of people who felt there was another round in this game. Troy, you've really got to prove that your chance to start an entirely new life with Dan wasn't sitting here on the table all along. The next three, please.
Number nine, Mikey, please.
Okay, Mikey, in these situations, we can always take one round hit of disappointment. He undoubtedly went one round too soon. So now, let's have one of those wonderful, wonderful rounds at the climax of the game where you do the perfect round. All three reds in these three boxes, Mikey. Give us one of them.
Here we go, Troy. Good luck, mate.
Cheers,
Mikey. Yes! Yeah!
Psy, 16, please.
Psy, we want the second component of this round. Second red.
So we can destroy this game, after.
Cheers, Psy.
15,000, oh, okay, yeah, so now.
Perfect.
21.
Yeah, I think there's a big one in Haley's box, that's why I didn't go there earlier.
It's going to have to be 21, isn't it? Tom, will you please open the box? We are really going to cheer if this is 75,000. It proves that you did go one round too soon, but hopefully we're going to strip the 75,000 out of this game. It's not on the table. Prove it, Tom. No! Oh, my word. Oh, no. No, 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 no. We did not want to get to this stage. I saw the tears well up in your eyes.
There'll be more this time, I expect.
The tears well up at 28,000. Hello. Yes, I would agree with that. The banker is saying one of us has made a very, very big mistake. The offer at this stage would have been £21,000. Okay. So, if I'm about to reveal £10, hopefully that will erase the disappointment and you will at least go away from here knowing you've beaten the banker.
Yep, that'd be good. That'd be brilliant.
Right. You got me worried now, Troy, because at 28,000 I saw your eyes glisten. No, no, we're not going to have the box of tissues. Came here with a dream of getting out of that single room that the two of you occupy. You got 15 grand to make life better. Could you have had five times that amount of money? Yes.
There's not really a lot you can...
Troy, you've got 15 grand. 15
grand, yeah.
You've got 15 grand in your pocket. In your pocket, that's yours. Come on.
Hayley, complete the game, please. £10 over there.
Sorry.
You did generate the most extraordinary level of love and support here in the Dream Factory today. How do you feel about it at this moment?
To go away with £15,000 is absolutely amazing.
I'm so pleased that we are actually helping your lives with £15,000. Big disappointment. And that is the biggest dilemma that you ever get in Deal or No Deal. A player who needs the money. It really gives the banker a massive advantage. Woo! Cracking game. We'll have another one tomorrow. Don't miss it, bye-bye.
Coming up, Greta Scacchi on The Paul O'Grady Show.